Hello and welcome to my course on functional programming. In this series of videos, I try my best to go through and explain functional programming in a way that I feel it's easy to learn, and I wished somebody else had explained it to me like this before. To get most out of this course, I recommend you have at least 1 to 2 years of experience coding so you can see the benefits and appreciate the beauty that functional programming brings to your day-to-day life. I'm using TypeScript in this course for teaching functional concepts, so having familiarity with TypeScript helps you a lot to understand the topics. But if you're using other languages, you can still follow and leverage the material and practices I'll introduce in this course. So what is functional programming? Functional programming is a way to think and design your solutions to your problem. You're probably already familiar with object-oriented programming or procedural programming, in which you're using variables and mutate them until you get to the result that you're expecting. Functional programming is different in a way that instead of mutating any states in your application, you define transformation declaratively and chain them together to solve your problem. As the name suggests, functions are in the center of your designs in functional programming. Functions are used to model your algorithms, but they also are treated as values and they can be passed around. How does it work? You first break your problem into smaller, simpler functions, and then by composing and combining those functions, you can get closer and closer to your desired solution. Don't worry if these don't make much sense now. We will look into each of these in details later. Something you need to understand in the beginning is that functional programming is not about language, but it's a way of solving your problems. So no matter what language you use, if that language can treat functions as values, you're good to go. I'll use TypeScript to teach functional programming in this course. Is TypeScript the best language to teach functional programming? Maybe not. There are tons of programming languages which are designed specifically for designing your solutions and programs functionally, like Haskell, PureScript, Clojure. The reason I chose TypeScript is because JavaScript is the dominant language for web developing in the time that I'm creating this course. And that's my domain of expertise. And I felt this gap in front-end engineering. But again, this course is not about the language. It's about learning the perspective of functional programming. Functional programming is declarative, meaning you specify what you want rather than how you want it, compared to imperative programming like OOP. How do we do this? By chaining our functions and transformations and then run our inputs over them. By limiting some things we can do, functional programming promises more control, which leads to fewer bugs and higher maintainability to your code. For example, we don't have for or while loops in functional designs. Those situations are coded with recursion definitions. We will look into function recursion calls and how to write loops with them later. And if you are feeling this is too limiting, you may not be wrong. But do you remember the early days of programming when we had go-to statements? Nobody is missing them these days. And all of us agree that having go-to in our code causes more harm than good. As you start using functional tools, you start seeing the benefits and stop missing the old imperative tools. And let me share with you a beautiful code I found in the book Functional Programming Made Easier by Charles Scalafani. Bad designs produce unexpected consequences, whereas good designs produce unexpected benefits. So finally, why bothering learning and coding functional? As you will see, functional codes are easier to reason about. You just read them linearly. meaning when you're reading a functional code, you don't need to keep all the possible paths of running code in your mind. It's only a straight path, which you need only to look into front and not back of your running code anymore. Functional languages and tools write a lot of code for you. You just need to tell them what you need rather than how you want something to happen. Because of this, you are just reusing what you're already created, which means less coding and more happening. We can put more responsibility to compilers to check our code. This means that a lot of bugs are captured at the compile time, which means that we don't need to write tests for those cases. This raises our confidence in our code. If something is compiled, it will probably work as expected. Because in functional programming, we are not editing values and functions are mostly not aware of outside of their body, we can reuse them anywhere. In other words, in functional programming, values are immutable and functions don't have side effects and are predictable. We look more into this later. If you love software engineering, you will enjoy this. I guarantee it. You can modularize everything and plug things together so easy that after you learn this, you will wonder, how was I not using this before? You will forget how life was before coding functional. And the last reason I want to mention is, because of all the benefits I mentioned, existing programming languages are borrowing more and more from functional perspective every day. They are adding functional features to their languages, like promises in JavaScript or lambda functions in Java. So it can be a good reason to learn these concepts fundamentally. And in the last, I'm gradually adding new videos to this tutorial. So in order to get notified, please hit the subscribe and the bell button and don't forget to like the videos if you do like them. See you in the next video.